just areas had to be closed, streets had to be shut, and that was often part of the dislocation of a raid. It wasn't only the debris blocking streets, but there'd be a UXB in the area which had to be defused.
Bombs causing idle factories, bombs paralysing railways, bombs blocking streets and thoroughfares, and all these bombs are UXBs.
It was the job of people like the Royal Engineers to sort them out. George Carroll was still at university doing a degree in engineering when he was called up.
The bomb would be uncovered, and when it was uncovered, it then became my responsibility, and mine alone. And I had to find out where the fuse was. And so we were armed with a torch, with a rod and a mirror on it. Now, by making a hole behind the bomb, I could actually put the torch in, shine the light on the mirror, and recognise the fuse, if it was there, and then you remove the fuse.
But they'd never know which fuse they'd have to face. The Germans started sending over delayed action bombs that were designed to cause additional havoc by adding a timer to the explosion.
The clock may be set to operate at any time up to 80 hours after landing.
When you got down to a bomb, the first thing you did was listen to it. Because if it had a clock on, it was going tick, 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 tick. So when I got to the bomb, I sat on it. Why? So that I would know nothing about it if it went off.
But there was even worse to come in this cat-and-mouse arms race. The Germans then introduced an anti-handling fuse. This was a booby trap deliberately devised to target the bomb disposal men themselves.
I was always aware that I might be killed. I didn't spend my time sitting down saying, am I going to be killed today? You haven't got time to think about that sort of thing. You've got a job. You couldn't allow yourself to be overcome by your feelings.
On Blitz Street, I'm getting a hands-on demonstration of how to defuse a bomb from Sergeant Doc Savage, a current bomb disposal operator from the Royal Air Force. It's a delayed action timer fuse, and there's just a small area at the side that it's safe to drill into.
It's quite tough. You really have to press pretty hard, don't you, before it even begins to bite.
Throughout this drilling operation, you still have to be quite careful, because any jarring may function the fuse.
Thanks for telling me that. Of course, it's relatively easy doing it here because we're on a flat surface and it's a nice day, plenty of light, but I can imagine that a lot of bombs wouldn't have been in this kind of position at all.
Potentially you can find the weapon in any orientation. You can find it sort of nose up in the air or even the fuse on the underside of the weapon.
I think I'm through, aren't I?
Yeah, we're through.
Then I have to create an airtight vacuum with putty so I can fill the fuse with liquid.
This is BD fluid. BD fluid is a mixture of benzol, methylated spirit, salt and a food colouring.
The benzene and meths act together to break down the insulation on the wiring so the electricity discharges safely.
Yep.
Now to remove the fuse by undoing the locking ring. If this was for real, this would have been the most nerve-wracking moment of all.
OK, now you've removed your fuse locking ring.
Yeah.
You attach a piece of string through the loop on the crab tree.
Yeah. Oh, it's coming. Oh,
yeah, that's not ideal, is it? The idea is you'd then retire to a safe distance and pull the fuse.
Oh, I thought I'd done really well then. I'm supposed to get back there and pull it up, am I?
You are, yes.
Well, I've done it, though, haven't I?
You've done it now, yes.
If that had been a real bomb, that one small action could have killed me. Little surprise it's claimed that the average life expectancy of a bomb disposal man was just 10 weeks.
I was lucky. I was one that didn't get killed. I was always aware that I might be killed, which is why, in a sense, I became involved with a girl, and I never admitted that to her. I wouldn't let my friendship with her grow to the point of being anything more than that because I didn't like the idea of my being killed and leaving her in tears, as it were.